Welcome! In this video we're going to make some quick patches with the new Grid plugin within Bitwig Studio 3.0 beta. My name is Matthias and let's take the tour! Okay, so in the new version of Bitwig 3.0 beta we have two new plugins. And if we go into our browser here, press Bitwig, we can see a new category called the Grid. And in this Grid we have the FX Grid plugin and the PolyGrid. Let's first look at the FX Grid. So the FX Grid is for processing audio, and I have loaded it on this audio track. And if we go into this plugin, we can see that we have two devices here. And if we press them, we will get the information about each device or each module within this information panel. So this is the audio input, the audio that comes into this plugin. Then we are routing with the cable here to the output. That's the audio that's coming back to the mixer within Bitwig Studio. So if I would drag a sample, let's find a, maybe that little drum loop. Let's drag that to our arrangement view and make sure that our mode, the stretching mode, is set to Elastic Pro. So that's our little drum loop. Now we can process that with the Grid, the Effect Grid plugin here. You can see if I remove the cable, we won't have any audio, but let's route that back. So now we can use all these devices that comes with the Grid here and come up with the cool effect manipulations. To connect any of the devices to the signal flow, we can either drag the effect out onto this field and connect the cables ourselves. We have to get rid of this old connection between the ins and outs and connect audio input into this comb filter and then the output to our audio output. So that's a very cool way of processing your audio. Then we can also further add some fun stuff. Let's add a modulay to the output. You can see we can also drag a device from here to any of the nodes and it will instantly create these cable connections for us. So that's a very fun way of processing audio. Okay, so let's load up the instrument version of the Grid, which is called the PolyGrid. So we go into instrument channel here, press the plus sign, go into Bitwig, the Grid, and select PolyGrid. And now we will have a basic triangle prepared for us, which we can skew and fold to create new interesting sounds. You can see that the cables are already created for us. And we have the triangle going to an attack release device. But I'd rather replace this with an ADSR instead. And to replace a device within the same device or module category, we can right-click the device. And since this is an oscillator, it will bring up the oscillators. So let's create a sine. And we can also connect this ADSR, send the modulation from this ADSR to our fold. To get some attack to our sound. Okay, so how about adding some more modules, maybe a delay unit? And now we can create a feedback delay if we want. There is a module which has feedback already, which is called mod delay, but maybe we want to create our own feedback delay. So let's feed the output from the ADSR into our long delay. And now we need to think about what kind of devices we need. We need to mix this delayed signal with our original signal. So how do we do that? Well, go to the mixer here, select the mixer, and drag our original audio into the mixer. Then the delayed audio to a second mixer channel, and the output from the mixer to the output. So now we have the delayed signal and we have the original signal. But we only have one delay at the moment. We want to have some feedback. Drag this blend module and blend the original output with the output of our delayed signal and feed that back to this delay. Now we have some feedback. And if we drag this blending more to the right, we will get even more feed signal. We probably also want to have some stereo manipulation, so we can add an LFO, the regular LFO, and attach this modulation output to this to the panning. Make that panning a little bit deeper. We have more stereo width. So that's how you can create your own feedback delay. Let's look at the other delay, the mod delay, which is already has prepared with feedback. Send a part of this signal to this mod delay and then back to the mixer. So we have a third delayed signal. Increase the feedback and a bit of filtering. And maybe add another LFO, which will control the stereo or the panning of this third mixer track. Maybe increase the ratio a little bit. Okay, so let's finish this sound up by going to the effect section and adding a little bit of reverb. So let's use the M Turbo Reverb and go to Large Spaces and Concert Hall. Okay, let's look at another oscillator. Then the sine, we have some other oscillators. Let's look at this swarm oscillator, which is can be really powerful, and connect that to the in. We can also activate some stereo spread. Yeah, so I hope you really see the power in this grid plugin within Bitwig Studio 3.0 beta. If you have any questions on the grid or Bitwig Studio, please shoot them in the comments below. If you have an active subscription of Bitwig Studio, I highly suggest that you go and download this beta and check it out for yourself, because it's really powerful and you can do tons of sound manipulation with this plugin. If you're new, please subscribe, like, and write some kind feedback in the comment section below. Now you can continue and watch my next video. Thanks for watching today. My name is Matthias. See you in the next video. Bye.